The squid and sperm whale diorama in the Milstein Hall is really fantastic because it's capturing a battle royale. Sometimes you don't even realize it's there. So you see this dark space on the side of the hall and you're kind of saying, well, what's that?
And as you move up to it, your eyes adjust to the light because it's in the darkness and you recognize the sperm whale.
You're focused in on the head area and what's actually happening in this moment where the whale's trying to eat the squid and the squid's trying to say, I don't want to be eaten.
But none of us ever witnessed this in real life. Architeuthis is the scientific generic name for the giant squid. So it means, like, you know, Archbishop, it's the biggest squid around. They grow to as long as 60 feet. The eyes are the largest in the animal kingdom. They're referred to as dinner plates. Size is a refuge from predation, because you get too big, who else is going to pick on you? Squids turn over food and make it into protein very rapidly, and so that's why we call them the broiler chickens of the sea. And squids are such good prey because there are a lot of them. Probably the giant squid has some predators as a juvenile because it's growing, but as an adult, it's hard to think other than a sperm whale really what does them in.
The sperm whale is the largest tooth predator on the Earth's surface. Even though it has teeth in the lower jaw, and they're quite large, they don't use that for feeding. They're what are called suction feeders. So you basically open this large mouth and suck everything in. They can dive to depths of 6,500 feet or 2,000 meters. That's the equivalent of 4.5 Empire State Buildings, one on top of another. They evolved this capacity to seek food in an environment where there are not a lot of other large predatory competitors. The giant squid represents a very small fraction of the diet for most sperm whales, but because they need so much energy, because they're big, they're very opportunistic. And so you come across some big meal, you're going to take advantage of it. Giant squid were only seen live over the last 10 years or so. So all the evidence that we have of this feeding is from indirect information.
If you examine the skin of a sperm whale, you'll see these large circular rings. And we suspect those are the sucker marks left by the giant squid as it clings to the sperm whale and the two have this ferocious battle together. In addition, when we look at the stomach contents, we discover the beaks, that is the biting apparatus of the giant squid in the sperm whales. And so we know that the battles ended badly for the giant squid.
There are two major reasons why it's difficult to study those kinds of things. And one is relative rarity. So if you think about a giant ocean, your chances of encountering a sperm whale or a giant squid is relatively small. The other is that the sperm whale spends time at the surface because it has to breathe air. The giant squid don't. They can live their entire lives at deep depths, and so we just don't see them at all.
There's a lot of evidence that's consistent with this hypothesis that there's a battle between them. There's nothing like hard data, though, and that is to say, having captured the scene live on video, I'm not sure we'll achieve it anytime soon. But this diorama, the sperm whale and the giant squid, is one of the iconic dioramas in our museum because it's so mysterious. And you know, there's still mysteries in natural history, and that kind of evokes the curious in all of us.